Welcome again to GMC Online Service. Happy Sunday to all of you, my dearest brothers and sisters, wherever you are. Please take your time together with us as we have our service to worship our God through this online service for today. And our theme for this Sunday is Greatly Rejoice, taken from the first book of Peter, chapter 1, verses 6 until 9. I'm sad and feeling blessed at the same time right now. You know, I'm sad just because that we are not able to have our fellowship in person in this sanctuary. After a long time, this situation is not getting well yet. And feel so blessed also. It's just because that we still have all this equipment so that we can do our service virtually through this online service that we have every Sunday. May the Almighty God be glorified in His heavenly kingdom. Now, our God is calling us to worship Him. Take heart, for we are gathered in the Father's presence today
to proclaim the wonders of the Lord.
Get up, for we are beckoned by the risen sun
to respond to grace undeserved.
God is calling us, for we are united by the Spirit
to follow Jesus on the way.
Come, let us worship God as we pray together today.
Praise the Lord.
Let us unite our heart in prayer. O Holy God, like Isaiah the prophet, we stand in awe of your glory, feeling tremendously small and polluted by our sin and the sin of our society. Even so, you touch us with your burning presence, and we are made clean and whole. O God, our Creator, continue to build this household of faith into what you want us to be. O Christ, our Savior, lead us to do as you will. O Spirit, our power, strengthen us for the work of the kingdom, a worship and a service which is ours today as well as tomorrow. O Blessed Trinity, fill this place and these people with your presence. For yours is the power, and the salvation, and the creation, now and always. Amen. Do you feel the joy from our God today? Yes. It's just because the love of our Lord drives our doubt away. For the hymn of praise, let us sing, Joyful, Joyful, we adore thee.
Oh,
Reading the Word of God is our duty every day to know His will. Our responsive reading for today taken from Psalm 8. Let us read it responsively. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens.
Through the grace of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies to silence the foe and the avenger.
When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place.
What is mankind that you are mindful of them? Human beings that you care for them.
You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor.
You made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet.
All flocks and herds and the animals of the wild.
The birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas.
Together.
Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Let us proclaim our faith in the affirmation of faith. Let us proclaim it together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Universal Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Again and again, we always love to greet you all. Have a blessed Sunday service with your family or to those who have a personal worship. God, through His Holy Spirit, is always be with us. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand, taken from Isaiah 41, verse 10. Our speaker for today is Reverend Sonda. Thank you for your ministry for today. And then the Methodist Church in District 6, Region 2, will carry out charity program from May till August to help the people whom affected by COVID-19. Please support in prayer and donation. You may send your donation through bank transfer to our church account and inform them to our treasurer as Charity District 6. And we would like to thank your participation so far. May God bless you all. Our GMC charity program for orphanage, our church is supporting and help the education of children in Damai Sejahtera Orphanage Batu Aji. For the school fee, there are 10 children that we are support every month. We encourage you to participate by your prayer and your contribution to help them grow in spiritually and physically through education. Thank you and God bless. Our midweek church activities such as small group, a women fellowship, men fellowship, youth fellowship, good news, club and visitation are temporarily be cancelled. And during this time, we will have an evening prayer at 9 p.m. every day. Let us be faithful to join us in this prayer. And then we continue with the building fund. Our building fund balance report for 31st May 2020 in total 195,902,000 155 rupiahs, and then 9,196 Singapore dollar. And then our GMC financial report in May 2020, a total ending balance that we have in our church balance is 49 million something, and then 4,686 Singapore dollars. Happy birthday to those who celebrate birthdays in June, to those our dearest brothers and sisters. May God, the Almighty God, bless you all. That's all for our announcement for today. We continue our worship for the song of prayer, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Heavenly Father, as you touch your prophet Isaiah with this living word, I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My soul shall be joyful in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with ornaments, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. We are currently worshiping you, and we are also experiencing this great rejoice with your presence in our life and ministry, despite with the pressure surrounding us because of the COVID pandemic. In the beginning, we start with the health issues, and then develop into economic difficulties that everyone is currently experiencing. Social unrest in certain part of the world. But our faith in you are never fade, and you are always be faithful to bring us out from these difficulties. Hear our cries, Lord, and forgive our sins, so we can be worthy in front of you. Strengthen our spiritual well-being to build a reliance defense from all the worldly pressures, and only rely on your help to carry our task to glorify you in every step of our life. We thank you for your provisions and health for the world, our country, and every individual life. Have mercy, O Lord, for all of us, especially for healthcare workers, nurses, doctors, ambulance drivers, and people who are behind the scene to bring the end of this outbreak. Be with them and give them wisdom and energy to carry on their task. Especially we pray for the group of your children who are preparing the online service to worship you and to bring the good news for others. They have been identified for the infection of COVID-19. May you bring your healing power upon them and calm their anxieties and people surrounding them with your peace and your love. Heavenly Father, we pray for the building team. Guide them to have your wisdom to find a suitable place for our church, parsonage, and ministry. Please provide the fund needed. We pray for all of our ministries in bringing the good news for others, feeding the poor, and attending the weak and weary, and our brothers and sisters who are ill to get speed recovery. We pray for Sister Hazel's mother, Brother Oriento, Brother Lincoln, and Brian. May you send the suitable doctors and medication to help them to recover as soon as possible. We rejoice to welcome your blessing upon the pregnancy of Sister Rishna and Sister Rina. We surrender both mothers and babies in your good care during their pregnancy. God of mercy, we surrender Grace Methodist Church into your guidance so all of us as church can walk faithfully, united and strong, together to dance with the storms of life currently surround us. We pray all this with the adoration to your name. Confess our sins to repentance, thanksgiving with rejoice, and asking your supplication with all faithfulness in our hearts. All of this we pray in Jesus Christ, the precious name. Amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give. Not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves the cheer giver. Taken from 2 Corinthians, chapter 9, verse 7. perpetual to have a doxology. Pray so this offering will be acceptable in the hands of our Father. Almighty God, we gather in the name of the one to whom all authority is given, Jesus Christ. As we offer you this money, you ask us to renew our commitment to be your faithful disciples. May our lifestyles reflect a desire to be in a mission for others. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. And now we are going to listen to the Word of God. But before we listen to it, let us have a hymn of preparation. The Lord my servant, I'll not want.
Blessed Sunday, brother and sister in Jesus Christ. Let us unite our hearts in a prayer as we prepare our heart, our mind, and our soul to listen to the words of God. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you, O God. With a joyful heart, with a rejoiced heart, we come to you this morning. For the Lord Jesus, as we want to meditate on the words of God, please bless us, anoint your servant with your Holy Spirit, and help Lord Jesus Christ, so every word that come out from your servant mouth, it is come from you. And all the listeners and all our congregation who will listen the words of God for today, may you speak to them directly, God, and may the words of God will be fruitful in their lives. Thank you, Father. We are ready to listen to your words. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us open our Bible from 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 6 until 9. You may open your Bible with you and let us read together. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 6 until 9. This is the word of God. In all this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while you may have had to suffer grief in all kinds of trials. These have come so that the proven genuineness of your faith, of greater worth than gold, which perishes even though refined by fire, may result in praise, glory, and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Though you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and are filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy. For you are receiving the end result of your faith, the salvation of your soul. This is the word of God written for the people of God. Brother and sister in Jesus Christ, there is a saying in Bahasa Indonesia, sudah jatuh ketimpa tangga pula. So if it is, I put in a English, simple English translation, I would like to say like this, after falling down, then struck down by the ladder. Because I don't know what is a saying in English for this term. People say this word, people say this sentence for others who have experience of difficulties that never end. So the first problem not finished yet, but then the next, the other problem come. The other problem not finished yet, the third problem come over to their life. So the difficulties never ending. None of us immune from their problems. Especially all believers, you and me. We have go through all circumstances in our lives. So, brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today's scripture bring us the understanding that Christians should be rejoiced and even having greatly rejoiced in facing many kinds of trials. The writer of 1 Peter is Apostle Peter. Peter was one of Jesus' disciples. His experiences with Jesus brought him to do ministry greatly. After all, the disciples filled by the Holy Spirit in the Pentecost day. The Holy Spirit power guided Peter to share the good news about Jesus Christ to all people who are non-Jews, to help people know Jesus and believe in him, to direct people to live in Jesus and no need to be afraid and don't move back from their faith in Jesus whenever they found difficulties in life. So, book of 1 Peter written to the God's people whom scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia at that time. So all these people, all God's people, all the Christians, they live under Roman authority according to that area. So what they got harassment and persecution. Not only the political issue, but the culture also became matter in the lives of them. And they were suffer. They were very painful. Therefore, Peter came with this letter to encourage them as Christians who believe in Jesus Christ. Therefore, in verse 6, if you look at your Bible, says like this, in all this, you greatly rejoice. This is what Peter mentioned in this book. Though now for a little while you may have had to suffer grief in all kinds of trial. So the word of God mentioned that we have to be rejoice, even greatly rejoice in our suffering or in our grieving because of the trials. And this message became the point of Peter to help the Christian people to be able to walk their day by keeping their faith in Jesus. So today we learned on how we can have the greatly rejoice in every suffering or in every difficulties that we face. Maybe we didn't face harassment or persecutions like others Christians experience, but every problems in life can make us lose heart. Therefore, we need this heart of rejoicing. Brother and sister in Jesus Christ, how can we have this greatly rejoice? Firstly, greatly rejoice will be yours when you know that you are special. This is very important. Greatly rejoice will be yours when you know that you are special. You are special when you believe in Jesus Christ. Because we are a chosen people. Through faith, we accept Jesus Christ, and by His grace, He makes us a new creation. We become part of His family kingdom. We have a new identity that we are the children of God. And as the children of God, we live in Him and walk with Him as our Lord and God, who saved us and bring us living hope through His resurrection. And He is Emmanuel that never leaves us. He will give us the Holy Spirit, whom our God, who dwell in us, so we can live our lives in the truth and in the righteousness. So when we know that we are special in God, we need to dare to be different with the Word. We live in the Holy Spirit that can comfort us every day whenever we face grieving. Suffering is temporary, but believing in Jesus Christ is everlasting. We accept the life that never perishes, never spoiled or fade, but it is kept in heaven for us. It is eternal life. So my dear brother and sisters, by knowing this identity, by knowing that we are special, we can be more calm to walk our day in God. When you know that God is with you, you may always say to every problems, "This too shall pass." You may say to yourself, "My God is bigger than my problem." And in confidently, we can say, "With God, I can do this. With God, I can overcome my problems." Secondly, how can we have this greatly rejoice? It is talking about Trinity, God of the Father, God of the Son, God of the Holy Spirit, whom live in us, is able to be experienced as long as we depend on God. Look at verse 8 in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 8 says like this, "Though you have not seen Him, you love Him. And even though you do not see Him now, you believe in Him and are filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy. Meaning, we still love Him and still believing even though we cannot see Him. And for those who can be still until the end of His racing life, we will receive the goal of our faith. It is the salvation of our soul. In Matthew chapter 16, verse 24, Jesus said to His disciples like this, "Whoever wants to be My disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow Me." Jesus never promised to His followers that the life will be smooth and nice, but He promised to be with us always when we deny ourselves and take up our cross to follow Him. I would like to encourage all of us, love Him, believe in Him, and depend on Him in every circumstances in our lives, because it will direct us to have greatly rejoice. The glorious joy that you cannot speak about it, but you can experience it with God. Brother and sister in Jesus Christ, I was in seminary school when there is a couple of husband and wife who came to fetch me from dormitory and bring us to church every week. So actually, there are two of us, me and my friend, that every week this couple will fetch us and bring us to the church. This couple was quite old, around 60-something, but their spirit to serve God was wonderful. Their ministry was to fetch and send me and my friends from dorm to church. So this is what they did every week. We like to call them like our parents, mommy and daddy, since they also didn't have children. So they love to serve us as well. They like to share their happiness and always rejoice in their simple life. But one day, the husband passed away, the husband died. So me and my friends, who always used to be with them every week, we were so sad and grieved. So we decided to follow all the funeral service. In the funeral service, I can see the wife that we call mommy without tears. Most of the people come and cry, but not in her face. When I hug her, I cry, then I just try to show that I also grieve and sad. But when I cry and when I hug her, she strengthened me. With her gentle voice, she said, "Our daddy is happy now, so don't worry, don't cry." But do you know what is in my heart? I said, "Why I am so sad, while mommy, while the wife, didn't show it? Suppose I am the one who strengthened her, but now she is the one who strengthened me." So suddenly I was confused. But after that, I realized this is rejoice in the Lord. Fully trust in God that everything gonna be okay. Though I know she lost her loved one, but to be rejoice in the Lord always, because he trusts God that his husband in heaven and happy right now. So I said to myself, one day I should have that kind of attitude like this mommy. Brothers and sisters, positive mind, positive attitude will help us to control ourselves in responding the situation. So though we cannot see God, I just urge each one of us, love him, believe in him, and depend on him. Thirdly, greatly rejoice in the midst of trials can be happen when we understand the purpose of the trials. Verse 7 in 1 Peter chapter 1 say, "These have come so that the proven genuineness of your faith, of greater worth than gold, which perishes even though refined by fire, may result in praise, glory, and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed." It gives us meaning that our situations, our sufferings, our difficulties need to face so it will prove the genuineness of our faith so our faith will be everlasting and strong in God. Genuine faith will never end, and the value is more than gold, which perish even though refined by fire. Do you still have faith in God? If this situation that happened to your life totally different from what you expect, faith in Jesus Christ will be still in every circumstances, because we know that every test will teach us the truth. Our situation right now, brothers and sisters, many people lost their job and very hard to find another job for them to survive. Do you still hold on to your faith or lose your heart because of the situation? The answer is yours. But remember that God never leave you, and he will open the way for those who are faithful in him and depend on him. I met with one friend. He lost his job in this pandemic. He was a tour guide. So for sure, no job at all and no income at all for him. So we met and he shared with us. And then he said, "I don't have job right now, but I thank God for this time. Why? Because this time makes me closer to God." Then I asked, "What is the reason why you said that you are closer to God?" "Yes, because this time I can use my time, I can spend my time to read the Bible every day." So he started to read from Genesis, and now he is in the book of Numbers. Then I said, "Please don't give up, because while you're reading the book of Numbers, is so many numbers there and so many names there. Please don't get bored with it. Keep reading." Then he realized, "Yes, you are true, Pastor. But I keep trying my best to read the Bible every day. I believe God teach me in this pandemic." This is what he say. "I need to be patient and fix myself in God first." So I encourage him to keep spirit and be faithful. God is doing something in your life. Brother and sister in Jesus Christ, the power of Holy Spirit is working in every believer when their faith connected always in God. God even can use us to be his witness in this difficult situation. God also wants to see our response as the followers when we are in different challenges. So let us have this kind of attitude to be rejoiced and having greatly rejoice every day by firstly knowing your identity in God, that you are special, that we are special. So we have confidence as the children of God. Secondly, let us experiencing God by love, by believing in him, by depend on him, although we cannot see him. And thirdly, greatly rejoice, it can be happen in your life, by knowing the purpose of the trials is to prove the genuineness of our faith. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. God bless you. Let us pray. Dear God, though sometimes it is difficult for us to apply all the words of God, this greatly rejoice is come from you. And we know it is the work of the Holy Spirit who dwell in us. Father Lord Jesus, it is not only temporary, but greatly rejoice, it is everlasting. Each one of us can experience this as long as we always connected with you in our faith. Father God, you are always keep watching over us. You will always take care of us. Help us to have positive mind and positive attitude in responding every situation in our life. And may the words of God who said, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice, it will be fulfilled in our lives. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Yes, brothers and sisters, we have just listened to the Word of God. The service is about to end. But before we end this service, that we still trust in God wherever we may be, upon the land or on the rolling sea, my Heavenly Father watches over me. Let's sing it together.
For crown,
In God, because He cares for each one of us. In every day of our life, let us put our faith in Him with a greatly rejoice. We can give our positive mind and our positive attitude in responding in every situation that we face. Let us receive the blessings from our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord may His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace today and forevermore. Amen. Let us respond together. To all of you, brother and sister in Jesus Christ, remember that God is always with us. And we also encourage you and invite all of you to share our YouTube channel of Grace Methodist Church Batam to your family, to your neighbors, or maybe to your friends. God bless you once again. See you next Sunday. Amen.